Good morning, students. Today let us have the revision of lesson 2 from English literature. Please have your book and the copy in front of you and we will do the revision together. Before getting into the revision, I want to remind you about this lesson. I suppose you remember. I have already explained and given you the gist in audio and the poem recitation recited one also I had sent to you. I suppose you have prepared yourself. But all the same, I'll just remind you about all about this poem, what it is. So the poem is about the happiness the poet gets from his picture storybooks. The poem is Picture Books in Winter, written by Robert Louis Stevenson. So he recollects the of the poet's childhood memories. So this is a recollecting, bringing back or going back to the childhood memories and feeling a kind of having a lovely feeling of sitting by this fire, looking at the picture books of his and dreaming of far off places on cold days. So it was a particular place where it was very cold, and that time the fireplace they used to sit, and the child, one who is saying, that child was turning over the pages and just explaining, having a feeling, and that is put it in the form of a poem over here. So this is all about this poem, but we are going to discuss now the question answers and the first book exercise A and B, and we have the C with the extracts. As I told you earlier, we will get multiple choice questions for your test. But remember, even from the question answers and from the extract short questions, you have to learn so that it may come for the exam and a test. Please kindly follow your book, page 15. We have the A. First, choose the correct words or phrases from the brackets to complete the sentences. It is a multiple choice questions given here. You have to select the first in a correct one and fill up. The mornings are dash. The options given to you here, the correct answer is frosty. The windows are fingers and toes tingle. T-I-N-G-L-E. Tingle means you get a prickling, no? You get a hurt. No, during the winter time, we all of us feel that it get hurt and it becomes reddish, and thereafter you get a little bit of pain. So this happens during the winter time. So the spelling is T-I-N-G-L-E. Number 3, the water turns to stone. So in that particular place, so cold place, the water even turned to stone. Number 4, in the books there are pictures of dash, sheep. Now as the child turns the pages, the child finds picture of sheep. Number 5, picture books show us flying fairies. No, in that most of the books are like flying fairies also. The imagination put it on the book, that's why we can say it is a flying fairies. So 3 options are there: goblins, fairies and elves. Elves also is a kind of fairy that we learn most of the time in the fairy tale stories. Number 6, the narrator reads the book in dash, in the garden, nursery nooks or the study. So study hall, nursery hooks is the correct, and nursery nooks is the correct answer. Now what is the meaning of nursery nooks? Nursery nooks already given here, corners set apart for young children to learn and to enjoy. Now we'll go for the question answers. Number 1, who walks beside the narrator? So the narrator's nurse walks beside the beside the child. Number 2, where can flowing brooks be found in winter? The flowing brooks can be found in picture story books. Number three, mention the pretty things that wait upon the children's eye. In what sense do we wait? So we have the answer. Number three, sheep, shepherds, trees and shepherds' crooks are the pretty things that wait upon the children's eyes. They wait for the children to open the books and see the pictures. Number four, which words tells us that the narrator sees things that are both close and distant? Now, close by and distant means far. So, here in the meaning of this particular words itself, we have the answer. Number four, answer, the words near and far tells us that the narrator sees things that are both close by and distant. Distant means far. Number five, whose appearance does the narrator see in the picture storybooks? The narrator sees the appearance of the flying fairies. Number six, do you think the narrator of the poem is a child or an adult? So after going through this poem, what do you think? Whether the narrator, one who is narrating, is a child or an adult? So give reasons for your views. The narrator of the poem is a child. He needs his nurse to take care of him when he goes out. The description, so now the word nurse is used, instead we can make out a nurse. Adult people are does not need a nurse to move about, but a child is required a nurse to do his or her things. So the description of his books contains pictures of sheep and shepherds and flying fairies. A child would naturally enjoy. So the very reason a book having with pictures, all these are enjoyed by the children, not an adult. He is portrayed, means put before or presented before us, sitting in the warm corner of his nursery reading those books. So feeling comfortable and safe by the side of his caretaker. So the child is looked after by someone, that is a caretaker or a nurse. So here we surely we can say the picture and here the lesson or the narrator of this poem is a child. Now we'll have the extracts number one. See that extracts, all short questions, please learn it so that you can get it even as a short answer. So prepare yourself. Summer fading, winter comes, frosty mornings, tingling tongues, winter robins, winter rooks, and the picture storybooks. So we have the first question, which word tells us that the summer is on its way out? So we have the answer, the word fading tells that the summer is on its way out. It means just getting out of the season. Number B. The poet mentions birds here and an animal later. Name the animal. So the animal, sheep is an animal, the poet mentions later. Number C. What does the poet talk about immediately after these lines? So the poet talks about the pond that is turned to stone in winter that he and his nurse could now walk on. In the same breath, or means to say, he is speaking about the stone in winter, that is a turned to stone, the water, the pond that is turned to stone, means it is so winter, severe cold, so even the water turns to stone. We have the second extract. How am I to sing your praise, happy chimney corner days, sitting safe in nursery nooks, reading picture storybooks? So we have the first question, whom or what does the poet wants to praise? So the poet wants to praise the days spent reading. Now it's just getting recollected the old memories of the childhood. Number B, pick out two lines in the poem that describe an activity away from nursery nooks. So happy chimney corner days and reading picture story books are the two main lines that is mentions about the activity away from the nursery nooks. Number C, pick out a word in these lines that tell us the narrator feels secure. The word safe tells us that the narrator feels secure. So these are the question answers and the extracts. And we have on page 17, rhyming words is also very important. You can just go through that, fill in the blanks with the words with that rhyme. Shade, late, made and rate. Bold, sold, cold and rolled. 3. Night, light, tight and sight. Number 4. Round, bound, mount and sound. Number 5. Scare, mare, tear, rare. Number 6. We have book, cook, look and took. Rhyming words has to be told with open mouth for the practice so that we know how we have to use the pronunciation and what should be our position of our tongue, our face and our mouth. Now, upper palate, lower palate, all these touching some syllables. So please practice this and get ready for your test.